Sydney rivers on the rise, like in the Hawkesbury, where they know flooding only too well.
Scary. I know, overwhelming to me.
And if they don't do something soon, a lot of people are going to pay for it.
With Warragamba Dam at over 96% capacity, close to full.
Warragamba will move into a spill, likely Monday morning.
It was coalition policy to raise the dam wall, not the government's. The Premier says it won't stop floods and is too expensive.
That's a $2 billion project. It's likely to take many, many years for EIS and construction, as well as the engineering works, to take place.
But for suburbs downstream...
We really are sitting ducks. We are not happy about the fact that the dam wall raising project has been abandoned. With the absence of any other mitigation measures, we actually feel our whole community has been abandoned.
In Pitt Town, they say promised flood mitigation measures like levees and better evacuation routes are yet to happen.
If there's a major failure with Warragamba or a big flood, we will be trapped.
The early impact of the poor weather, but like here in Pitt Town, often the biggest threat is what's called blue sky flooding, or the water that arrives when conditions clear.
The spill will occur likely when the rainfall event has moved on.
Emergency crews warning locals not to be complacent.
What we don't want is the roads to be clogged, the evacuation routes to be clogged.
And the latest advice from the Weather Bureau is that minor flooding is likely on the Hawkesbury, Nepean and Colo rivers from tonight. And the Hawkesbury and Nepean rivers could see moderate to major flooding from Saturday morning. There's also a major flood warning for the upper Nepean, with the Nepean Dam expected to start spilling on Monday. But bear in mind, those warnings could be updated and changed depending on the amount of rainfall.
Okay, Chris Maher in Windsor, thank you. And the big wet is already playing havoc with a big weekend. There are three key cancellations tonight. West Side Story on the harbour is off, along with the Barangaroo Beach Cinema and the Blessed Nights Festival at Liverpool. However, Ramadan Nights at Lakemba is proceeding. Tomorrow, the Star Championships race day will go ahead at Randwick, subject to a morning track check. The City of Sydney's Crown Street Festival is also on, along with the Red Line Games at Penrith. The sunset session at Cockatoo Island has been moved indoors. And for Saturday sport, wet weather and flooded fields are likely to cause mass cancellations for netball, football and league. Check online with your club for the latest.
So for the very latest on this system, let's bring in Angie Asimus now. Angie, good evening to you. What are the current warnings?
Well, there are many, Michael. Warnings cover flash flooding, damaging winds, big surf, even cold temperatures. This is the zone that's being impacted by rainfall. It stretches from about Wyong right down to the border. Localised 24-hour rainfall totals of 70 to 120 millimetres are likely, up to 150 millimetres in the Blue Mountains and the Illawarra. This system is noteworthy due to the scale of it, with falls over almost every forecast district in New South Wales. The heaviest, though, by far have been in the east, so we'll see that weather ramp up south of Newcastle this evening, then gradually shift down the coast tonight. The most intense period will be through until tomorrow morning. I'll be back with the latest soon, plus a look at what's in store for the start of the school holidays. Angela and Michael.
Okay, thank you, Angie.